movie review on the internet today, the A-List Review. I am your host, Wes Troop, and guess what day it is? It's another Anticipation Friday! And you know what that means? We're gonna look at a film that reminds me of a movie that's coming out this coming week. Something to do with it, right? This coming week, today, Megamind opens, starring Will Ferrell and Brad Pitt on the voice crew. Oh, and Tina Fey, of course. And I thought I would review another film, animated film, that has to do with superheroes. It came out in 2004 by Disney Pixar. I thought I would throw it in here because I really enjoyed it. I thought I'd throw it in as a Wes's fave pick as well, as an Anticipation Friday pick. It is The Incredibles, Disney Pixar. All right. So, The Incredibles, that came out in 2004. That's 6 years ago. Holy crap. Wow. I remember going to see that in the theater. Sees a family of undercover superheroes who are forced into action to save the world, as most superheroes are. Ask the West Side there. After trying to hang it... they're trying to save the world, but after they've been trying to hang it up and live a normal, quiet life, they don't want to do the superhero thing anymore. But sometimes they sneak out and try to relive the old days. So, some of the cast. Craig T. Nelson plays Mr. Incredible, also known as his regular name, Bob Parr. Holly Hunter plays Helen Parr. Her superhero name is Elastigirl. I knew a few girls back in the day by the nickname Elastigirl. Check that out. Samuel L. Jackson, one of my A-list favorites, plays Frozone, or Lucius Best. Frozone is a good character. I like Frozone a lot. Jason Lee plays the villain, Syndrome. Definitely a good voice cast there. I thought it was a great different kind of cartoon for Disney Pixar. You know, they had Toy Story, they had Bug's Life. I think this was after Finding Nemo, yeah. You know, they had those films, which were great, great kids movies, but this is a superhero film. It's one of the first animated superhero films that I know of. I'm not counting Fox Kids with X-Men and Spider-Man, Amazing Spider-Man and whatnot. Those are cartoons on TV, but this is one of the first great superhero movies animated that I've seen. And, you know, I think it's a great family movie that fits in with the current superhero craze. A craze that I hope doesn't stop anytime soon, because I love me some superhero movies. So, definitely, I thought it was a good flick. It has good action, good comedy, some drama in it, some adventure. It has a little bit of everything for everybody. The voice cast is good. Holly Hunter's voice kind of got on my nerves a little bit, but what can you do, right? Whatever. I wish Samuel L. Jackson had a little bigger, more of a part, because I liked his character Frozone probably the best, actually. I like Samuel L. Jackson a lot, so it was cool. It was cool to see him in there, though, as an animated character. I was waiting for a couple F-bombs, though. That would have been great. Disney would have been sued for that one. I think all of Pixar's movies are just great. There's not one I haven't seen that I haven't liked. You know, Toy Story, Bug's Life, Toy Story 2. I haven't seen Cars. I heard that's one of their weaker ones, but Monsters, Inc. I like. Up. Oh, God. WALL-E, of course. You know, they're all great classic hits, and, I hope people my age and older who don't have kids will check them out, because they are very good films, great films. You might be missing out on something if you think, that's a kid's crap. You know, what do I want to watch some kids movie for? You know, they are some of the best movies of the year, actually, when they do come out. So I always try to make time to go and see the latest Pixar flick. So definitely good. And I didn't even cry in this one. So imagine that. I didn't even cry. There's supposed to be a possible sequel. They had ideas for this. Incredibles, it actually ends with a possible sequel idea. But They put that on the back burner for now. Right now, the plans are scrapped because they're going to do Cars 2, Monsters, Inc. 2, whatnot. I would definitely be interested if they would put out Incredibles 2. I'd definitely go see it. So I'm sure a lot of other people would, too. So, therefore, the A-List gives the film The Incredibles the rating of A-List Approved. Gets the A-List seal of approval, baby. So, everybody, have a good weekend. Go and see Megamind. That's probably going to be my BOP for this week. Check it out on the A-List. Definitely we'll see what that brings. See what Megamind brings. Maybe I'll see that and review it. We shall see. So, until the next time I see you all, till then, Troop out.